Welcome to Perfect Word Media, folks. We are the Lynyrd Skynyrd Christian family of Northeast Alabama, and this is the Ten Commandments. The Lord says, if you love me, the Lord, you will keep my, the Lord's, commandments. No other gods, worship no thing, only God, no taking God's name in vain, no disrespect for Sabbath, no disrespect for parents, no murder, no adultery, no thieving, don't kill the truth, no desiring what is not yours. Folks, I don't like people reading to me. I'm not going to read to you. I was going to read the lyrics to a couple of songs, but I'm not going to bother. Don't have the time, folks. Imagine, because your million-dollar property mortgage is almost paid off and down to just $40,000. That's all the bank has in a million-dollar property. And imagine your sheriff and your two bankers and your lying lawyer, Jimmy Carnes, all execute a conspiracy to destroy your life and your family's life. And you're the Lynyrd Skynyrd Christian family of Northeast Alabama. You're in the finance business, the transportation business, the music business. I mean, it's just unfathomable. What's unfathomable? Believable, but impossible to understand. So they all conspire to destroy your life and your family's life and your businesses with child rape slander because your chief financial officer, Roger Coit Chapel, is proud that he was a Boy Scout master for 20 years in Clearwater, Florida, where he outlived four wives. He was almost 100. He raised five boys and two girls, and the five boys were raised in the Boy Scouts of America. He never did anything wrong. He never hurt anybody in his life. They used that. They capitalized on that, and they killed him with that. It's recorded on audio recorders, even his response. He said, this is against me. Yeah, you're right. Welcome to Marshall County, Alabama, USA, where the devil reigns in the name of the Lord. These people are the Antichrist. They don't miss a Sunday service, and they conspire to rape, rob, pillage, slander, steal, kill, destroy, and set on fire with real fire and child rape slander in their satanic God's name. They've justified. Yeah! Yeah! We got people hollering and supporting us now. Thank God they see the light. They're now saying, you know, Marshall County's crazy for real, and they embarrass the voting public. It's true. They're saying, I can't believe the county thought they could get away with this one. They've attacked blind people, elderly people, disabled people. Blind people in Helen Keller County, Talladega. A cotton farmer's daughter in DeKalb County, 83 year of age, white female. They're going to take her down with their wicked Bible and the law. And these people are insane. Put them right where they belong, in a cage, federal or state. And either get right with the Lord, turn state evidence, or go to jail. But anyway, they conspired to do it, and they did it. They ruined our lives, our family's life, our occupations, our social standing. It's all blowing back on them now, just like the Supreme Court case when they extorted us for $5 million. Just like a meth lab in an Albertville City trailer park, it just blows up right in their face, and they end up in the emergency room at Marshall Medical South with their skin dripping off of them, wondering what hit them. Well, you were cooking meth with children in the kitchen. Not smart. What are you doing? Wake up. Be grateful for the blessings God has given you and stop being an ungrateful, blooming idiot. It's a danger to yourself and others. Truth always brings the darkness to light. God, thank God we have an awesome God. But anyway, folks, in their conspiracy, they use child rape, slander, and other forms of violence, including bank fraud and rampant theft against us, just to ruin us. Just legal discrimination and mob violence. And they've done this to my family for 160 years. They did it on Buck Island. That's why we have an island in the background. It's a reminder. This is the Marshall County Mafia killing my family for 160 years for their land. And these are radical religious zealots. They just find a religious justification. Oh, yep, we got a mandate from heaven. God wants us to rape, rob, pillage, slander, steal, kill, destroy in his name and get that land by all means necessary. Folks, it's spiritual nonsense and they act on it. They are very embarrassed because they were not counting on you. They were not counting on you, much less you on YouTube. That's what they were not counting on. It's a game changer, folks. Our founding fathers are very proud of the First Amendment's power and authority on YouTube. You can't stop a train, folks, and our founding fathers got it next to perfect. All we got to do is hang on to what they gave us. All we got to do is adhere to these Ten Commandments, even if you are a Buddhist or a Muslim or any other form of human. You can't disagree with it. You should not violate the Ten Commandments whether you are Christian or not. I mean, it's just good stuff, okay? Don't get lost in the labels. Just learn to love all things good and realize God is synonymous with good. The term God is synonymous with good. So, folks, it's just legal discrimination and mob violence ordered and are condoned even by your county judges because you stopped them years ago from extorting you in a $5 million extortion scheme, a $5 million cash judicial and jury tampered extortion scheme that was sorted out in the Supreme Court of Alabama, case number 1051726, Federal Credit Inc. versus Greg Fuller. But with no financial redress for you, imagine that. We didn't get a dime. They just blew up our lives. They claimed qualified immunity. Then they come back to rob our bank again. We own 23 finance offices in five counties, employed 36 full-time employees, and provided stellar financial services, small personal loans, automobile loans, even mobile home loans through a privately owned finance company. We were, in essence, a financial conglomerate. Some people would call it a small bank. But the judges robbed the bank and got caught. And they've come back with the sheriff and our bankers. That's Chris Bailey of Liberty Bank, DeKalb County. Geraldine, Alabama, where Miss Eugenia was born and raised and still resides on her home place, 80-acre cotton farm that's now a cattle and mule farm. I had to get rid of my horses because I could not afford to feed them because of all this sabotage. I want my horses back. But anyway, the extortion scheme was sorted out in the Supreme Court, and they issued a scathing rebuke that just made Marshall County judicial system retaliate more violently. They stopped them, but it was with no financial redress for us. And then they've had me sexually assaulted in all this, trying to scare me off my mother's property. I mean, folks, it's rape. It's murder. Yeah, it's the wrongful death of Brother Chapel. It's the abuse of blind Sonny. King Sonny, he's the second and only one of two original Elvis Aaron Presley Memphis Mafia members. It was not a criminal syndicate. It was a nickname given to Elvis Aaron Presley's entourage of bodyguards that looked like Secret Service agents with black sunglasses and black suits and white shirts with a black dress tie. So they lovingly nicknamed Elvis Aaron Presley's bodyguard entourage, about 12 people, as the Memphis Mafia. And Margaret Lacey is from Memphis. She's the banker that's the evil mastermind that conspired with the sheriff after she gave away all of Miss Eugenia's bank savings, $40,000, when the Supreme Court ruling was released. She wanted to gain favor with the Marshall County authorities then, and they awarded her zero. Miss Eugenia was given zero restitution in that $40,000 theft, where the county covered for Margaret Lacey for giving away Miss Eugenia's money under the guise of cash and stolen checks. It's all orchestrated, folks, and are condoned by the county, evidenced by the court orders and the just relentless abuse by them. We've got attorneys saying these judgments are illegal, they're biased, they're absolutely unconstitutional. They violate the letter and spirit of the law, and they claim qualified immunity. So they had me sexually assaulted because I'm Miss Eugenia's chief executive officer. I'm now also her chief financial officer because they stressed to death her chief financial officer, Spiritual Grandpa Chapel. Someone recently said, it sounds to me like your chief financial officer just didn't pay your property taxes or your bank mortgage and you got foreclosed on. We've not been foreclosed on, people. Please pay attention, please, with all due respect. We've not been foreclosed on. We've never been late on a payment. The county has moved to try to force us into foreclosure through child rape slander, rampant theft, and other forms of sabotage, and they're bragging about it, and people are coming and telling us. It's a scheme to force us into unjust forced bank foreclosure. It's kind of like Nancy Kerrigan getting her kneecap busted so Tonya Harding can win the Olympics ice skating championship and become a multimillionaire through endorsements. And who did that? Who busted Nancy Kerrigan's knee? Tonya Harding's husband, right before the Olympic trials. That's what they've done to Miss Eugenia. They've busted her metaphoric kneecap so she couldn't pay her mortgage. She's paying it. They just try to make us stumble and fall. They're going to stumble and fall right into a jury of their peers. We need a grand jury convened. We need an indictment for the leaders. That's both officials and corporate leaders of Marshall County. It's all in order to steal $1 million prime commercial real property for only $40,000. So imagine, because your mortgage is almost paid off, your sheriff and bankers and other so-called righteous Marshall County and DeKalb County leaders move to destroy your 83-year-old mother and your life. They want to destroy our lives. And my mother's physically disabled because she picked cotton for 2 decades. She has 5 deteriorated lower back discs. She lives in chronic pain and wears a body cast, a custom-made lower back brace that goes from her shoulder, underneath her shoulder, right her armpits, down to her hip bones to support her deteriorated 5 deteriorated lower back discs. They all know this. Chris Bailey, Margaret Lacey, Sheriff Phil Sims, Jimmy Carnes, John Allen Smith, the chiropractor, Timothy Francis Riley, Mitchell Floyd. They all know it. They see her as defenseless and her friend, blind man, King Sonny. and Roger Coit Chapel, a.k.a. Spiritual Grandpa Chapel. They just see us as defenseless, and they have moved to take $1 million property from us after we stopped them from trying to steal $5 million cash. They want to steal our lives, folks, our liberty and our property. Folks, the sheriff, Bill Sims, theft targeted my family. Again, disrespecting and misusing the badge and the gun to try to give our $1 million barely mortgaged land to his banker female friend, Margaret Lacey, vice president of Cadence Bank. And he used his guy friend, Chris Bailey, president of Liberty Bank of Geraldine and Albertville, Alabama, too. Keep us in your prayers, please. And happy birthday, America. Like, share, and subscribe. Pray for us. We pray for you. God bless you.